Final Fantasy Brave Exvius announced that they would be giving all players a banner that promises 11 units. All of these units can be awakened into their 7-star forms, so at first glance this banner doesn't seem like one that should be missed. But then you look at the price tag, and with many other things, it kind of makes you want to look away. But still, 10,000 Lapis for 11 powerful units is a pretty good deal, right? The answer to that, unfortunately, is a maybe. This will vary greatly depending on the units that you do have, and the amount of them that you have already summoned or possess. By the way, this is advertised as a refined pool, meaning Gumi cut down on the amount of units so we can get a better quality. And all in all, they did a really weird job, cutting it down to what they consider a fair number of only 128 units. I don't know what they're thinking. On the one hand, they cut out units like the First Lightning and both versions of Delita. But at the same time, they cut out units with good Trustmaster rewards like Squaw and Rinoa. With 128 units in the pool, each individual unit will have a 0.78125% chance of being summoned. And while that does sound low, and admittedly it is, this is the time you have to take those basic math skills and apply them to real life. Now, there are 128 units in the pool. Getting one of them is a 1 in 128th chance, which, when converted into a percentage, is 0.78125%. That's for one summon. We get 11 of them, so now we multiply that number by 11. That gives you about an 8.27% chance of getting the unit that you want. For the record, that's a pretty good chance for a rare character, and much more generous than it lets on. You know, just saying this makes me realize how much the game beats down on the players. And that's without taking into account the false rates Gumi gave us for Item World. But wait, that number is only assuming that you only want one unit. If you have two units that you like, you have about a 15.91% chance of getting them. Well, one of them at least. If you want three units, that's more than a 22.96% chance of getting one of them. If you want six units, you have about a 41% chance. If you have more than eight units that you want, you have a greater than 50% chance of getting one. If you have 15 units, that's about a 74.62% chance of getting one as well. And if you want one unit out of 30, well, that's at least a 94% chance. Needless to say, this is an incredibly high value banner, especially according to how new you are at this game. Of course, it does come with a steep cost of 10,000 Lapis, so I do recommend you gather as many free Lapis as you can before it comes. Anyways, while they did cut out a bunch of old units, there are still many more included in the pool. So if you want to know if a certain unit is in there, then ask away in the comments and I'll answer below. It's honestly best if you ask before you summon, because a fair warning. If you're a fan of someone like Squall or Ramza, neither of them are in the summon pool. By the way, if you haven't used your Final Fantasy VII summon coins yet, make sure to watch my video where I help you choose them. Though you might not think it's that difficult of a choice, there are quite a few things that should be taken into account. The exchange shop will close in a week after this video has been released, which is just enough time to pull on this banner. Just a note, Cloud and Sephiroth cannot be pulled from this banner, while everyone else can. I already selected Sephiroth with my first summon coin, so I've already got my bases covered in this regard. Regardless, I plan to pull on this banner, and even if I do get a bunch of duplicates, I'm at least closer to getting a Neo Shiny Super Trustmaster reward. If you liked the video, make sure to subscribe and leave a like. Again, comment below if you have any questions. This really isn't an event to shrug off carelessly.